Jess Salgueiro é uma atriz lusodescendente com muito sucesso na televisão canadiana. Além da participação em séries e longas-metragens, trabalhou também na criação de peças experimentais, onde se inspirou nas raízes portuguesas.
Nos últimos dois anos, a luso-canadiana Jessica Salgueiro, natural de Winnipeg, na província de Manitoba, tornou-se uma das atrizes mais familiares entre o público canadiano e internacional das diversas séries de televisão produzidas em Toronto, entre as quais as populares Orphan Black e Saving Hope.
I've been seriously so fortunate in 2017, just with Mary Kills People, which I'm really proud of, Working Moms, which I love, and I'm starting second season next week. Saving Hope was amazing. I've done a bunch of shows this year already too, called Condor, The Bold Type, and also another really great project that I've been involved in is my website called bitchesbewitches.com. It's a place where we talk about feminism, we talk about the experience of being a woman and living in a masculine-minded world.
Jessica integra também o elenco da premiada série de comédia da CBC, Kim's Convenience, sobre uma família coreana, dona de uma loja de conveniência, onde a atriz luso-canadiana encena uma personagem sul-americana na nova época a estrear este mês.
I'm so glad to be working on this show too. This show is about a family, an immigrant family that has this store that you experience so many different ethnic groups within the store, and I grew up in the exact same way. My dad's store was a hub to not just the Portuguese immigrants, but the African immigrants, the Hispanic immigrants, like Pakistani, everything. My father is from Akanena, and he came to Canada when he was 17 because he didn't want to fight in the war in Angola. My mom is from a little town called Santa Barbara, which is near Faro in the Algarve, and she came to Canada when she was 8. There seemed to be like a lot of people in their community and a lot of other cousins and family members moving to Canada, and Winnipeg at that time specifically was supposed to be this the hot spot, like where there was lots of industry, lots of mining, they needed lots of laborers, and it also was affordable. Me and my sisters all danced in the Duranchu. I felt a bit spiteful having to spend every Friday night at the association. but now when I look back at it, I think it's beautiful, and I'm so grateful for the community, and I feel that they're, I'm so happy I grew up with that. I went to musical theater school, so in college I got trained to sing. Show tunes, music theater. After I graduated, I spent some time in Lisbon. We went to a Casa do Fado, and I was stunned that I'd never made a connection before, that how this music seems to lend itself to the vocal range that my body sits at naturally. And also just the passion, the putting it all out on the table, that kind of artistry or that kind of action and craft is just everything that I adore about being a performer and what I personally try to seek in the roles I play or the material I do. I want to be as raw and revealed as possible. Speaking parts or Portuguese-Canadian parts are very infrequent. Love when they come along though. It's an interesting question of why aren't we seeing more Portuguese parts? We've also followed the footsteps of the American shows and the archetypes that we see on American TV. So we're used to those archetypes as well. So it's just a matter of I think telling our own stories, keeping it close to home and unique, and I really feel that people want that now.